Hi friends, Poor, a short story by Luigi Pirandello, which is enlisted in our text Issues That Matter, which is part of our second sem exam. And as we know, Luigi Pirandello, an Italian writer, playwright, short story writer, and famously known for his new wave of writing in and a new wave of plays, and he is famous for the short stories also. And we come to the short story. Its setting, the setting is in a train carriage, in a train compartment in Italy. It takes place in Italy. The backdrop is the First World War. So the story goes through the events of First World War in a train carriage, and the place, exact place is the place is Italy, and the time is morning. It is in the morning the short story starts. So atmosphere, the mood of the setting, the mood of the short story is sad, nostalgic, and to a certain extent optimistic. People are sad, people are pessimistic, people are doomed, but at the same time there are certain persons who are optimistic, and they keep hope in their mind. And the third one is internal conflict. So internal conflict and external conflict, two facts are in the short story and which contributes to the climax of the short story. So internal conflict, their sons are in the war front. That is their internal conflict. They are actually worried by their worried by the presence of their children, their sons in the war front, because war is going on. First World War is going on, and any time they can be killed, and they can be injured, and they can be brought back to home, sometimes as dead or sometimes as injured. So their sons are in war front. And external conflict, competing about who suffers more. So external conflict is that in a carriage, in the train carriage, these people are, they are traveling together, and they are aware of the situation, and all are sad, and they wanted to have a discussion of the current situation, and that discussion, everyone tries to elaborate their own sufferings as the most one. They want to there is a competition going on to tell or to express whose suffering is the most one, who suffers most. And the last one, the resolution, the main character woman realizes that she doesn't need to cry anymore. So people are suffering a lot, and people are crying, and they suffer a lot because of the war, and their sons are away, they are alone, and they want to have their children back. But at the same time, at the end, the woman and all others feel that there is no room for crying. They have to be optimistic, and the patriotism, the love for the country is the best thing. And their children are away, and they are because of the war, because of the love for their country, that's why they are in the war front. Okay, so main characters, husband and wife, they board the train from Fabriano. So it's a late night train. It has already started in the journey in the last night from Rome. So it starts in Rome, and it reaches Fabriano, and it goes to Salmona. So three places are there: Rome, Fabriano, and Salmona. And so there are people who have been boarding since last night in the carriage, and they traveled last night together, and they reached Fabriano. And in the Fabriano, the husband and wife, they enter into the carriage. So there starts the actual story. They leave Rome to see the sun. So the husband and wife, they leave Rome and they are going to Salmona, and they want to see their son because his son is going to war front. So they wanted to have the last sight of the sun, and they wanted to talk to that their son. And the wife is mournful and grieved. Husband and wife, the wife is mournful and grieved. She is crying all over the time, and she is so sad and tired. And other persons are co-passengers. Co-passengers are there, and they are also they have been also undergoing the same situation. They are worried about their children, and most of them are going to Salmona to see and to give a send off to their sons. And in the last moment, in the climax of the short story, we find a fat, bald, old man, and he speaks of patriotism. He speaks of patriotism. It is he who first introduced the patriots of their sons, and their sons are in the war front. Either they are died, or they are in the war front, or they are injured just because of their love for their country. Nobody pulls them to the war front. It is because of their love for the country, their patriotism, nationalism. That's why they are there. So this is the background of our story, settings, main characters, and we come to summary. In summary, we find the short story. In the short story, we find train journey starts in Rome. It reaches Papio in the morning, and it goes to Salmona. And when the short story starts, a couple enters at Fabriona. So we talked about couples, why husband and wife, they enters at Fabriona. Wife is mournful and grieved, and husband has to explain to the co-passengers why she has been crying and why she is so worried and so grieved. So he explains, at first he explains what happened to their child. They have only one child, one son, and that son is sent to the war front. He is about to leave his military place to the war front. So they want to see see their son, and they want to give him a send off, a warm send off. That's why they are in the train, and they travel to Salmona to see and send off their child, their son. All passengers in the compartment are in the same dilemma. Their sons are either killed or they are in the war front. So the same situation. They say the same situation for every people, because war is going on. And war has been the background of the short story, and they suffered a lot. So throughout the short story, Luigi Pirandello wants to tell the impact of war on people, the mental dilemma, psychological imbalances, and the trauma the people suffer. So all these things are inside this short story. And while hearing all these things, a woman speaks up and says that her son had left for the war front the first day of war, and he was sent back twice because of injuries, and he was sent back yet again. So after hearing the story of the husband, and people react, the co-passengers react with their own stories, and it is just to console the woman, and they wanted to tell her that they are also suffering, they have been suffering, and all people in the place, on the carriage, are suffering. So no need of any more cry, and they wanted to console her. So woman speaks up about her own son who have been sent to the war front in the very first day when he joined in the military, and he was returned, he was brought back to his home injured, and when the injuries are healed and when he got the health back, he was sent again to the war front. So he's in the war front, and she's also going to Salmona to see his son, whether he is happy or not, whether he is okay, how is his health, and she's also worried. So it's a reminder to the husband and wife that war is going on, everybody is in distress, and everyone has the reason to cry and mourn. So be calm, be quiet, and console yourself. That's the message conveyed by the woman. Then another woman stands up and adds in that she has two sons and three nephews, and they are in the war front. So she has two sons, and they all are in the war front with two nephews. So she has the reason to cry more than any other people in the carriage. So they have the other two women, they had lost, or they had two children, two sons in the war front, but she has two sons in the war front. Then the husband defends her. So the fat old lady who entered the carriage in the Fabriona, she has been mourning and weeping, and she never talks to other people, she never cares, but she listens to anything others say. So the husband defends for her, he defends her by saying that this is the only son, they have a single son, and he is in the war front. The others may have more than one children, and they have other sons and daughters to console them, comfort them, and to love them, but this family, this husband and wife has, they have only one child, one son, and that single son is deputed to the war front. So that's why she's so worried. So there starts a discussion about the correlation of the love for their sons and their suffering. So they relate their worries, their sufferings, with their sons, their love for sons. So they love their sons more than anything in their life. That's why they suffer a lot. That's why they are suffering. So other people in the carriage, they share the same message. We have the suffering just because we love our children, our sons. So that's why we have suffering. So there is the short story writer, Luigi Pirandello, he speaks of the correlation between the love of love of children, love of sons, to the suffering people have. And each one tries to highlight his own her own sorrow as the most sacrificial. So it's our psychological instinct that to exaggerate our own suffering and to have a predominance over others' suffering. So when we exaggerate our own suffering and make our suffering as the most important one, and I am the person who suffers a lot. So when we present ourselves as something, are the person who are suffering a lot, we will get a mental consolation, mental comfort. It's a psychological fact that we do in our exams. While after completing the exam, when there is a discussion about the easiness of the exam or the hardness of the exam, we usually tell it was not good for us, it was not good for me, and I lost everything, I will fail. So all these things make us comfort. So that's why the people say, I suffer more than you, and my suffering is the most important one, and I have the all the reasons to suffer. So all these things, all these arguments come out from the people to just because they want consolation. Everyone wants consolation, so they are consoling themselves. One says he has two sons but lost one in the war. So another person says he had two sons and he lost one in the war. So the husband then retracts. He defends by saying that those who lose one son, he has another son to love, and another. If one is left, if one is lost in the war, another is left to console him, and for his comfort and for his happiness, one is left. So, in this case, this husband and wife, they have only one child. But the passenger responds that such a man has an obligation to live for his other son and thus can't end his misery at his one hand. So then the other person, the other man, other passenger retracts and he says that when one child is dead, one son is dead, he has to take care of father. He has to love him, he has to comfort him. He has to take care of all his needs, and the father, the person is still in dilemma, still in suffering. So he wants to continue his life for the rest of the child. He cannot end his life until that son gets a permanent happiness or permanent job or a welfare stage. So he has to wait for until this situation. So he has to suffer the loss of the child. At the same time, he has to comfort the other child. He has to take care of the other child too. So another passenger, a fat, bald, old man, breaks with a speech. So this person was listening. He has been listening to all the comments, all the descriptions, and all the arguments. And he has been calm, quiet, and he never made a comment. But at the end, he made a beautiful speech, a bold, assertive speech. He asserts that their children don't belong to them. Your children are not yours. It's not yours. As Khalil Gibran, in his famous poem, the prophet says, your children are not yours. They belong to somewhere else. So don't teach them your ideas, your ideologies, your customs, and let them be what they are. So the same thing is argued by that fat man. He asserts that the children, once they are born, they do not belong to their parents. They belong to the country. They have interests of their own, including a love for their country, and they gladly fight for it. Their sons are in the war front just because they love their country. They are ready to even sacrifice their life for the country. So the children, they are not the sons. They are not part of the life of the parents. They do not belong to them. They belong to the country. If they don't want tears, they don't want tears because if they die happy. A person who fights in the war front, he dies happy. He dies happy because he died for a cause. There is a great cause for behind his death. Even if he faces death, he never regrets about his decision. He never regrets about joining the military, but he dies happy. He is so happy because he belongs to the country. So here we find the patriotism in the short story.
patriotism or nationalism is told through this fat man. This fat man speaks of nationalism and all those things. That's why he doesn't even mourn the death of his own son. So at the end, he concludes that he practices the same ideology he spoken out. Because his son has died, he lost his son in the war front. He had a son, and the only son lost his life in the war front, but he is not at grieved. He is not at regret about it, because that son, his son belongs to the country. So he had a happy death. He died happy, and he died proudly. So he doesn't want to mourn the death of his own child. He stops with trembling voice and watery eyes. He stops there, and he's so sad, but his face is bald, but his eyes are wet. Teary eyes. His eyes are watery, and but no drop of tears never come out. Tears never come out. No drop at all. But he is so bold, so assertive. He is so courageous to tell that he never cries on the death of his child, because he belongs to the country. So that is the situation. Then all the other passengers congratulate the man for his stoicism and bravery. Stoicism and bravery. Stoicism is being away from all kinds of pleasures or inadequate desires. So keep yourself what you are, and you have to be calm, you have to be quiet. So that is stoicism. So others congratulate him. He seems contented until the grieved woman suddenly asks a question. Then, is your son really dead? So the grieved woman, she speaks only at the end of the short story. She speaks only one sentence, but that sentence is so thought-provocative. Then, is your son really dead? She asks the question. The old man looks at her, tries to answer, but he can't. He seems to realize for the first time that his son is gone forever. So he realizes that his son is gone forever. And it's the fact his son is dead, and he lost his son. And so he understands the fact at the particular moment, and he weeps uncontrollably. So the question made by the grieved woman, that woman, it contains certain elements, whether he is not worried about the death of the child, or whether he understood or whether he acknowledges the death of his child. So that's why he cries, he breaks out, he weeps uncontrollably. So this is the story. We don't find any twist or any unusual climax in the story, because it's just about war and its after effects and the trauma, the mental condition made by the effects of war. So it's a beautiful story about war and its after effects, as the entire module is formed or structured on the after effects of war. So how do you find the after effects of war as traumatic, as shocking in the short story? That's the gist of the short story. So this is a beautiful short story by Luigi Pirandello. And we come to the themes. Death. First, we find death is part of war, and people suffer a lot. In the First World War, every family suffered the same fate. They had to face the death and the loss of their children, loss of family, loss of their own places. They had to shift from one place to one place, another place, and they had to travel a lot, and they lost their family, lost their society, everything they lost. Smartness. People become smart just because the effect of the war. Here the woman, husband and woman, the woman is so worried and uncontrollably she is worried, and she could not control herself. Even the husband could not. She is worried about his child, and she even ignores her own husband, and she's so angered at her husband. So madness is seen through the short story, and patriotism is seen through the old fat man. He speaks of patriotism. According to the old man, old people love their children more than the country, but young people love country first. So that is the gist of patriotism. So this is these are the things included in the themes. So it's a short story by Luigi Pirandello on war and its after effects.